can't imagine it's true. Our souls. In exchange for just one more day.
Stevens, can you hear me? Look at me, Stevens.
She wants it out. Can we take it out?
He's breathing over the vent.
All right, let's pull out the tube. While you are sleeping, while you're far away dreaming, I could spend my life
in this sweet surrender. What you reading?
Yeah, this patient I'm trying to diagnose is driving me nuts.
So take a break, I miss you.
Right here.
No, you're not. You're here, but you're not here, and I miss you.
Please, come on, try and work.
I'm wishing for a brain tumor. I'm wishing all the time for a giant tumor that would just press down on my brain and make me hallucinate George. So that I could talk to him again. So I could laugh with him again. I miss him so much. I miss him all the time, and I just want to feel better. Even for a minute, you know, I just want to be a person who isn't wishing for a brain tumor just for 1 minute. And I can't drink because of the cancer meds. I don't do drugs. I can't even work right now. I don't have any distractions. I'm sad. I miss George, so please, please, come inside and help.
Real seductive.
I don't want to close my eyes. I don't want to fall asleep, cause I miss you. Are we waiting for Dr. Swender?
No. Dr. Swender has handed you off to me.
What are you, like, second year?
Sir?
That's, can we page Dr. Swender or some
Stevens? This is a good thing.
It is. You still have cancer. But not enough to interest Dr. Swender anymore. It is a good thing.
You're saying I have GB cancer?
I'm saying your meds have shrunk way down. And there are no new ones. The protocol is working very effectively.
Stevens, this is about as good as the news gets.
So what now?
We're going to use the port in your chest to continue with your IL-2 regimen for now. And we'll continue monitoring the progression of your disease with PET scans every 3 to 6 months.
Is there some kind of timeline on this, or...?
Your wife is living with cancer, Dr. Kurev. Right now, the cancer has stopped growing. With a cancer this aggressive, that's pretty stunning success. There's no timeline. There's just, we watch it. We wait. We hope it doesn't start to grow again.
That's it?
That's it.
So bad. The thing we gotta try to remember is that it can turn on a dime. What is this?
Be my husband. Get undressed. Get into bed and hold me. I don't know what you're so mad about, and I don't know what you're scared of, because you won't talk to me. But I'm scared too, Alex, and I can't... If you won't... If we're gonna have any chance at a life together, then I need you to... Please.
You died in my arms. You died in my arms. You freaking died, and then you left instructions that I wasn't allowed to save your life. You wanna know what I'm scared of? I'm scared of everything! I'm scared to move! I'm scared to breathe! I'm scared to touch you! I can't lose you. I won't survive. And that's your fault. You made me love you. You made me let you in. And then you freaking die in my arms.
Holding out exactly what I want.
That's how you stay alive. When it hurts so much you can't breathe, that's how you survive.
You're messing around, I figured you out. You're taking me down, but I would be feeling it anyway. Cause nobody loves me like you do.
What are you doing here?
Working.
Is. We talked about this. You're supposed to be taking another 3 weeks, really resting up.
I have to come back now before I don't have a job.
You're playing it cool. I know what you do. I feel like a fool, but I would be feeling it anyway.
You keep feeling like I'm sick. My patients need to have faith in me. What are you doing?
Your wig is crooked. I'll stop hovering if you stop acting like an idiot. I need to speak to Dr. Stevens, please.
Alex, I'm in surgery.
Izzie?
Alex, please. Dr. Shepard, could you please tell Dr. Karev to leave?
Karev,
she gets tired walking to the mailbox. She can't handle another 5-hour surgery.
I know what I can handle.
No one's gonna think any less of you if you walk out of here now. Just walk out now.
Stevens, have this conversation outside.
No, I'm not leaving. Alex!
And boy, you know it's bad when you do that.
Thank you.
One more section?
It's 2 o'clock, Izzie!
Oh my God,
Stevens, I'm not fighting you anymore. Come get this.
It only makes things worse.
I forgot he was dead today. For a few hours in surgery, I forgot I had cancer and I forgot he was dead.
But George is dead. And he do have cancer. I want you to keep doing what you love. You're a great doctor. And you have a fantastic future ahead of you. But you gotta step up and start taking care of yourself. You gotta take your meds, you gotta eat. You gotta pace yourself. Because I can't be your nurse. I can't.